Hello, and I'd like to welcome you all once again to the old farmhouse on in the village of Reef on the west coast of the island of Lewis in the Scottish Outer Hebrides for another one of our wee half hours. And this is number 216. And before I start, I have to tell you, we had a couple of little crises. I just came up a couple of days ago, and one of the things that I left behind back in Butterstone was my wee guitar mic. But luckily, Lewis and Callum and Tanya and Lewis are here as well. And Callum has got a karaoke machine, and he had a microphone for his karaoke machine. So we've got it strapped to the microphone stand here. So we hope that's going to work. It's not maybe not up to our usual high standard of guitar quality, but you can't do much when you're away on the West Coast. The island. So we'll see how we got on. It's been a beautiful, beautiful day. The wind's been incredible windy the last couple of days, but tonight the wind just died down, and it's a beautiful night out there. And for those of you who have never watched one of these shows from Reef before, this is the old part of the house. This is the old part which I just left, and it's just exactly as it would have been. And we hope that it's always a challenge broadcasting from here, and we just hope that you're getting this loud and clear. From up here, she said, there is no compromise. Seen them laughing and they ran up to their eyes. So we'll start again. I had a little senior moment just at the very beginning of the show. From up here, she said, there is no compromise. I've seen them laughing, they run up to their eyes, and all their clever words are whistling in the wind, whistling in the wind. From up here, she says, you get the widest view. Someone's watching, no matter what you do. And if you hesitate, they'll steal away your time, steal away your time. You must not look down. You must not look down. Watch them fall and you're sure to follow. You must not look down. You must not look down. You must not look down. The hands are full and their hearts are hollow. You must not look down. Yours is mine, he said, and mine belongs to me. Take the climb, and many others are coming up behind. And soon the child will view the clearer day, see the clearer day. You must not look down. You must not look down. Watch them fall and you're sure to follow. You must not look down. You must not look down. You must not look down. Their hearts are full and their hearts are hollow. You must not look down. From up here, she said, there is no compromise. Seen them laughing, and they're in up to their eyes. And all their clever words are whistling in the wind, whistling in the wind. From up here, she said, you get the widest view. And someone's watching, no matter what you do. And if you hesitate, they'll steal away your time. Steal away your time. You must not look down. You must not look down. Watch them fall and you're sure to follow. You must not look down. You must not look down. Thank you very much. And that's a wee song, my wee song called You Mustn't Not Look Down, a wee song about life. And it's a strange wee song. But anyway, I'm going to do a wee song now that the Global Choir could have a wee go at this one. And this is kind of connected to up here because the people that that lived around the village of Reef, they were all cleared out of their little crofts in the kind of 1800s to make way for the sheep farmer who eventually lived in this house. And a lot of them would have emigrated to Canada and to Australia. And this wee song is about that. And I haven't done this for a number of... I've got some requests, actually. I'll read them out. That song was requested by Ali Fisher in Bear's Den. Hi, Ali. And this wee song was requested by Fraser Walters from Bundaberg in Queensland. Now, I've just come back from Queensland, actually. I was there over Christmas, and it was fantastic. I stayed in Bundaberg, just outside Bundaberg, in a wee place, a wee campsite, I rented a motorhome and we stayed there and went out to the Great Barrier Reef. And it was brilliant, and everybody was, it was funny, everybody was out snorkeling on this amazing place, the Great Barrier, looking for turtles. And I'm not a great swimmer, so I didn't really go out doing the snorkeling thing. I stayed on the boat that was out there. And I was standing at the railings, and I could see all the people snorkeling away, looking for turtles. And this great big turtle just swam right below past the side of the boat. And nobody saw him. And I was the only one that saw the turtle. And I hadn't even gone in the water, which was brilliant. So this is... So all you sing is... I'm leaving. Fortune's sweet pleasures to find. I'm sailing out to Australia. It's more of a kind of, I'm sailing out to Australia. If I've got the breath to do it, I'll see it. So here we go. And we'll be accompanied tonight by the wonderful strains of Murdo Tattyface, who's looking like he's had a few drams already. Now, Mr. Tattyface came up with us this time. You might have noticed that. And he went away out for a wee trip around the village, doing a wee bit of visiting, and he hasn't returned. So I suspect that he's fallen in with some of my neighbours and is partaking of the water of life somewhere. So we'll try this. Because he never came back. We'll see him later on, probably. Now that, now you've changed that fee for nothing, all right. That's right. Now that the storm has broken, now that the winds blow cold, there's nothing here but trouble and fear to make a man grow old. And now that our reasons are failing, now as the walls tumble down, there's nothing to hide but hunger and pride. Won't make a man look round. So I'm leaving, yes I'm leaving, all fortune's sweet pleasures to find. I'm sailing out to Australia. And now that our dreams are illusions, now now that our future has gone. We've nothing more to hold our Leor, to help a man hold on. And now as our hearts lie so heavy, now as our heads hang so low, there's nothing here to catch or come clear, to help a man say no. So I'm leaving, yes I'm leaving, of fortune sweet pleasures to find. I'm sailing out to Australia. And they say there's gold and there's silver. They say a man can come clean. Just stake out some land and reach out his hand and touch that new world dream. And they say it's warm and it's pleasing out in the New South Wales sun. And so I must go from the cold highland snow, now that the hard times have come. So I'm leaving, yes I'm leaving, of fortune sweet pleasures to find. I'm sailing out to Australia. Well, we have a wee global choir attempt at this chorus. It's quite easy. Here you go, on your own. I'm fantastic. I'm getting a global choir vibe here in the old farmhouse. I think we should maybe do it again, actually. It's sounding brilliant. And I know there's quite a lot of Australians who kind of watch the show, so this is a chance for the Aussie global choir to kind of sing out. Here we go. You sound hide. but hunger and pride. What make a man look round? So I'm leaving, yes, I'm leaving. All fortune's sweet pleasures to find. I'm sailing out to Australia. We'll do one last time and see how loud we can get it. So I'm leaving, yes I'm leaving. All fortune, sweet pleasures to find. Sailing out to thank you very much, and that's my wee song about going to Australia. And I was there for a month. It was it's amazing. It's an amazing part of the world. I love going there, and I love the animals there. I love the big dangerous snakes and things, and the dangerous spiders. And I remember talking to somebody. I met Ernie Dingle one time, and I asked him. I was saying, I need to buy a little book, you know, so that I can recognise all the poisonous spiders over here. And he said to me, he says, "Oh, don't worry, mate." He says, "You don't need a little book." He says, "They're all poisonous." And so I love it though, because there is a kind of, creates a lovely kind of tension. I'm going to do this song. This was requested by a wee guy, now if I get this right, for one of the youngest members of our global choir. I hope he's watching tonight. And it's his sixth birthday. He's called Holden Burgart, and he lives in Nashville. And he asked me if I'd sing this song, so I'm going to do this. This is a song I wrote in Canada, and it was after visiting a place called Head Smashed In, which was a buffalo jump, which was a kind of cliff, a 200-meter cliff in the Canadian prairies, where the Native American Indians would drive the buffaloes, so they could kill a lot of buffaloes all in the one go. They would drive the buffaloes towards this cliff, and there was a kind of funnel where they were concentrated. And then because of the optical illusion of there being the plains and then the cliff and then the plains, the buffalo would just all tumble over the cliff. And once they started tumbling over, the ones coming behind pushed the next lot, and it just came that this big, in the song I call it the waterfall. And it was called Head Smashed In because I think one young brave had decided to show off and show how he could be stand at the bottom of this. And of course, once it started, it became quite overpowering, and I think he got kind of squashed against the cliff edge, and that's why it was called Head Smashed In. I don't know, I remember somebody telling me that's... So we'll try it, and this has got a good chorus for the global choir. I'm a child of the great Cree nation. See me, I'm my father's son. We live by the great bull. See me, I'm the wild one. This morning we are ready to show the buffalo our knives. And by the red of sunset, will have relieved them of their lights. Buffalo jump, feel the thunder. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. Buffalo jump, feel the thunder. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. Well, the beast has well been gathered. We could have had 1,000 more. We'll run them to the edge. They'll tumble out through death's dark door. Soon the blood will flow like water through the sun-bleached ancient bone. We'll revive this dusty land on which our seeds of life are thrown. Buffalo jump, feel the thunder. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. Buffalo jump, that's what you sang, kill the hunger. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. See me, I am the bravest, I'm the strongest of us all. I'll stand beside the river's edge and watch the great black water fall. I'm a child of the great Cree Nation. See me, I'm my father's son. We live by the great Boo. See me, I'm the wild one. Here we go. Buffalo jump, feel the thunder. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. Buffalo jump, a bit of global choir on their own. That's a nice easy V chorus. And we've just been joined by my friend Finn, who's up the back there. Hi Finn. Here we go. Buffalo. I'm a child of the great Cree Nation. See me, I'm my father's son. We live by the great Boo. See me, I'm the wild one. This morning we are ready to show the buffalo our knives. And by the red of sunset, we'll have relieved them of their lives. Buffalo jump, make a bit of noise. Feel the thunder. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. Buffalo jump, feel the thunder. Buffalo jump across the plains. Buffalo jump, kill the hunger, crashing over the cliffs of pain. Crashing over the cliffs of pain. Crashing over the cliffs of pain. Thank you very much. And that's my wee song that I wrote up in Lethbridge in Canada, which is up there. And I was actually very lucky to be able to go and visit the whole, because below the cliff there was a mound, a kind of mound. And the archaeologists believed that they looked at it and they believed that the people had been killing the buffalo there for something like 20,000 years or something, 30,000 years. Now, there's a big visitor centre there now, and I think you can. I had a friend who was telling me when he was a wee boy, he used to go out onto this mound and he would dig down, him and his pals would dig down through the bones and find these amazing flint arrowheads and things and that. Because there was layers upon layer and layer of bones, because the hunt was every kind of year, I think. Anyway, it's a fascinating place. If you get a chance to be up in that part of the country, you have to go and visit it. And I'll do one more wee song, and this wee song I've sung it a couple of times, I think, before, and I've just got to change the tuning back up to. And it came from me. I was invited to go and visit a hospice for terminally ill children. It was really kind of, I thought it would be a very sad place, but it turned out to be a very kind of happy, lovely place. And because I did some work for a charity called Nord of Robins, who provide music therapists for a lot of hospices and things. And so I was invited to go down, and I was really privileged to be invited into one of the music therapy sessions with the music therapist, and they brought in this wee girl, and she was obviously really, really sick, and she was in a chair and she was all held up and she had pipes and everything kind of, and she had this kind of gaunt look on her face, and they wheeled her in, and the piano player just the music therapist just started playing the piano and started singing the wee girl's name, and all of a sudden the wee girl's eyes kind of opened up, and there's this kind of life in her face, and she started kind of reaching out, as almost if I thought it was like she was trying to catch the music, you know. And music's a very powerful thing, and so I wrote this wee song afterwards, and I've just got to check. And somebody requested this, I think. My wee request. This was requested by Julie Edmonds in Berlin, and Gary Jenkins in Portugal. Now, I was in Berlin years and years and years ago. It's an amazing place. In fact, the very first time I sung my Caledonia song to the public was in Berlin, in a place called Quartier Latin, I think it was called, if I remember rightly. But anyway, I'll wish you all a happy Easter as well. I've got it written on my wee thing here just to remind me that you're all have a great Easter. Hope you all have fun rolling your Easter eggs. And so this is, I'm going to have a wee mouthful of my port here. I brought some of Nigel's port up. I'm just joking. Oh, I went down the wrong way. I was so excited about I was so excited. I hope we can get through this song now, actually. Anyway, I'll show you about, yeah. I might have to have another mouthful of it just to straighten things out here. Yeah. That worked. So, here we go. She plays a little tune, sings around the room, dances through the air, and sparkles everywhere. A simple melody, gentle harmony, a door will open wide, and you will run outside, and you will fly away. For a moment freed from one more endless day. Oh, you hold out your hand to show you understand, to try and catch the light that's shining oh so bright. The blinking of an eye, so many reasons why. It's a gift from those who care. You can, it'll take you anywhere. Oh, and you will fly. fly away. For a moment freed from one more endless day. Oh, and time releases all the great and mighty fall, and fortune fills the skies with magical surprise. A simple melody, a gentle harmony, it's a gift from those who care. It'll take us anywhere. Oh, and we will fly away for a moment, one more endless day. Oh, she plays a little tune, sings around the room, it dances through the air and sparkles everywhere. A simple melody, a gentle harmony, a door will open wide, you will run outside. Oh, and you will fly away for a moment freed from one more endless day. Oh, and you will fly away for a moment freed from one more endless day. Okay, thank you very much, and that brings us to the end of our wee broadcast from Reef here on the west coast of the island of Lewis. The forecast is great for tomorrow. There's supposed to be no wind and the sun's going to be shining, so I'm looking forward to that. Hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for joining us. Thanks to Duncan Tattyface for his wonderful bass harmonies, as always. To Jamie and Callum, who've been working the buttons up the back there. And to Jenny and to Finn, who's been singing up in the corner. And Tanya, who's through in the other room. Tanya and Lewis, who are through in the other room, kind of monitoring this to making sure it goes out okay. And I hope Callum's mic, thank goodness for Callum's wee karaoke mic. And I've never used a karaoke mic for a guitar for a guitar mic in my life before, but it just shows you that, was it expensive, Callum? I can't imagine it was. But anyway, I hope it sounded okay. And all I'll have to do now is just hope that you're all looking after each other. I'm getting cooked by my peat fire here. In fact, I'm just going to, while we're here, I'm going to just throw another cup. This is what we burn on this fire. We'll get it fired up. And I hope you've enjoyed your wee half hour with us. And hope you're all looking after each other, staying cheery, smiling like a tatty face. And I'll see you all next week back in Butterstone. So, Aikava, night night. Bye bye.
Thank you.